You're on?
Okay.
Okay. Good afternoon, good evening, and good morning, depending where you are right now. My name is Marcia, and in name of you experience, I'd like to thank you all for joining us at this webinar. You experience is a pool of Brazilian higher education institutions, and it has as a main goal the improvement of our international activities and connections. One of these activities is to promote a series of webinars, especially during the COVID-19 pandemic. And this live streaming will approach the topic brand communication during the COVID-19 crisis. It will be given by PhD Florin Nikita, Vice Dean of the Faculty of Sociology and Communication at Transylvania University of Brasov. Thank you, Professor, for accepting our invitation. I'd like to thank also the Transylvania University of Brasov for their support. If you have any questions or comments, please write down at the chat. We'll be pleased to answer. This live is being recorded, and it will be available at our YouTube channel and our educational platform afterwards. Hope everybody enjoys our webinar. Please, Professor Florin, you can start now.
Okay. Obrigado, Marcia. I'm very glad to be here again. I hear some echo.
I guess it's from YouTube
okay, in this case I will turn off the YouTube.
Yes, you can turn off the sound of YouTube. Yeah.
Okay, so I turn all the YouTube. I cannot see now the comments on the YouTube, but I will see the comments on this platform that we are connected. So please tell me if it's some technical problems or not, and also I will look for the comments and questions of the students. Yes. So first of all, let's start with seeing from where our audience came from at this moment. Kindly ask you to write in the comment the university or the city where university is located, because UX is a wonderful project that I heard I learned more a few weeks ago when I was in Virginia, and I'm really enchanted to be guest in your network. So it's like turning back 6 weeks ago or 2 months ago, going back in Brazil. It's my second country, if I can say that.
Oh, great. And it's a pleasure to have you here also.
Okay, so let's start. This is something about me. Maybe you ask yourself why it's that beers in that photo. It was one of my first photo that I took in Virginia 2 years ago, and this happened because all the time when I'm abroad and I go in the supermarket, or small or big, I'm not without wanting to go there, I found myself in front of the beer shelf, even if I'm not a heavy beer drinker, just because I work many years, 12 and a half, almost 13 years, in the beer industry as different positions in marketing and trade marketing, and I'm very used to go to this shelf. So if I, for example, I saw the prices, I saw the assortment of the beer, I can compare in my mind with what happened in Romania, and this in this way I know it's I'm the, let's say, a very known ground. Then I worked for 1 year in the bottling water, again, marketing position, another 2.5 years in the dairy and milk industry, 1 year in the event management, and since October 2012, I'm the full university teacher at the Transylvania University of Brasov, and here I teach marketing communication or promotional tools, brand management, and creativity in advertising. This was my my experience in Brazil. In the left side, it's my last trip when I had 2 weeks of teaching. Actually, I wasn't in Cataguases because it was floods, and this this teaching have to be cancelled. And also on the map, because it's there, it's São João del Rei, because on the other map from the right side, it's not it cannot be seen. There it's put together all my 3 years of Brazilian experience, because the first time I was only in Virginia and Tiradentes in 2018 in April at the conference, at UNIS conference. Then last year I was at the UFMG in Belo Horizonte, and also I visited Ouro Preto in in a Saturday, and also 2 days in Rio, and at the end of February I had the opportunity after after the teaching session in Virginia to have a short trip, 3 days in 2 days in Curitiba and another 3 days in Florianopolis, only to see new places in Brazil others than Minas Gerais. Mm-hmm. Okay, so now let's present something about my city, because my university, Transylvania University of Brasov, it's located in the city of Brasov, and maybe you are thinking there, Corona. What means Corona? Corona is the Latin name of my city. It's in Latin, Corona means crown. And the second one, it's a German name. So Kronstadt, that means city of crown. So Latin name is Corona, German name is Kronstadt, and Brasov is the Hungarian names. Why? Because it's a very multicultural city. 120 years ago, here was the population of the city was exactly splitted in third Romanians, third Hungarians, and third Germans. It was founded by this part of the city was founded by German colonists in the 1235. Actually, before, but in that year we have the first written mention about this. Mm-hmm. And it's a city with about 270,000 inhabitants and metropolitan area of almost 400,000. Something about my university. My university, Transylvania University of Brasov, have 18 faculties with almost 20,000 students, most of them bachelor students, but also almost 20% are master students. Staff members, in these staff members, 735 teaching staff, 100 bachelor degree programs, 70 master's programs, and also doctoral studies in 18 fields. Basically, our university of 18 faculties, half of the faculties from the left side are engineering faculties, mechanical engineering, technological engineering, until the food and tourism or product design and environment. And on the right side, it's a non-engineering faculty, humanistic faculties, business and mathematics and computer science. I belong to the faculty of sociology and communication, a faculty quite new, was founded 10 years ago, and we have five bachelor programs and three master programs. The newest bachelor program, it's digital media, and we plan to start a new program of digital media in totally in English next, actually October 2021. So in 1.5 year, we hope that we'll start this new program in English, and hope that will attract students from abroad, why not from Brazil, from all the network. Yes. Okay, so let's go to the... Oh, I forget my question. All the time I have my introductory question. In order to warm up the audience, I ask my students, which is the first word that came in your mind when I said that I'm coming from Romania? And almost all the time, all the time, students said that it was Dracula. So now I'm I forget to put this question and ask you to put in a comment. So but this slide anticipated the your answers. Let me go to the chat to see if have some comments. Sorry.
we have comments from
YouTube. Okay.
Your students and also a professor from one university here in Brazil, Professora Larissa, as I can see here, they're just saying good afternoon and that they are here. Your students from the marketing class, Julia.
Oh, okay, so we have here a Romanian-Brazilian Romanian-Brazilian course. I'm yes. Very happy because we open this cooperation on the students level, on the mobility of students level, with at the beginning of this academic year, because one Brazilian student came from the law faculty, came in Romania, and yes. Followed by a Romanian student that go in Virginia. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, because of this COVID-19 crisis, he decided to come. He returned in Romania 2 weeks ago.
Yes.
But he, Nicu, he will be enrolled, will stay enrolled at UNIS yes. For the second semester, because he will combine, will have exams in Brazil online. And also right. Will be our student, the same, still online. I don't know in Romania when we'll return to the offline classes, maybe at the beginning of June. So I'm very happy that, and also Talita, I don't know if Talita is here. He's now in Brasov, he's the student of our faculty of business. So now going back to the full screen.
Yeah.
Okay. So the influence of COVID-19 crisis is, let's say, multi-layered, multifaceted. So influence on the hand the people at the consumers, from the topic of our of my presentation, influence economy, and we didn't know exactly how deep will be this influence, mainly negative influence in the future, but also there are some will be some positive outcomes. Different categories of the products and services of the industry, brands, and of course the main topic of my presentation, the influence upon on brand communication. So let's go to the rest. So first, the influence on consumers or the influence on people. The first, let's talk about Maslow. So even the pyramid of Maslow in this time, it's a revisited, it's a changed pyramid, not because of the joke of the first layer. You know, probably you saw that that joke that at the at the inferior part of the pyramid was added this more important needs than physiological needs, that being Wi-Fi, and then another joke added this battery or energy. But not talking about this joking part of the pyramid, we're talking about the classical model of the Maslow pyramid. Now, some of the needs are mixing. Let's imagine the people that are buying now, online especially, but not only online, because people are so are allowed even in countries that lockdown it's more tight to go to the shopping in the nearby. They are buying food. This food, it's only for satisfying a physiological need, or maybe sometimes this food it's part of the process of self-actualization. The answer is yes, could be also part of the top of the pyramid, because we saw a lot of non-professional or amateur master chefs. So a lot of content on the social media with people that are cooking and experiencing new recipes and sharing with others, or even attending different cooking tutorials on the on the YouTube. So in this case, buying that food, that ingredients, it's part of the self-actualization. And also why it's Maslow pyramid revisited in this time, some needs like self-esteem, it's almost rewritten. So we are not buying now goods and services in order to make us to reflect a better image of us than we are in the reality. So a lot of perfumes, a lot of clothes, cars that are usually bought in order to project another self of us now disappeared. So now it's more important the physiological needs, of course, safety and security, and then a lot of needs that belongs, because now we have more time for us, for self-actualization. Also changing habits about what we are doing in the house. So they're changing a lot of our habits from this point of view. So new needs, new products, new services that can fulfill this change. Also will be a lot of challenges in the near future, not speaking about medium and long term. That means will be a lot of threats for many categories, for many brands from different categories, and for others will be opportunities. Also, media habits changed. So now, staying in home, we are consuming more media, but even the percentage of this media, it's let's say different. So it increased more YouTube. Why increase YouTube? Because we are creating there like some kind of our universe, because Facebook or TV, it's full of bad news. Yeah. And on the YouTube, we can create our own universe based on our interests. So YouTube consumption increased more, or increased with a bigger rate than Netflix compared with the TV.
Yeah.
And also new digital consumers and shoppers appeared overnight. Yes. So people that in few weeks ago, they are not used to pay online or paid online only for some categories. Now they are regular online buyers, not speaking about professors. So professors that didn't have any experience of teaching online, now they are like having the black belt in the different platforms, and knowing which is the platform that that is better for small groups and other platform for bigger groups and so on. So we are forced to change in a very few, very short time. Okay, then what happened with the people in this in this period? What they are changing? I took this slide directly from the presentation that is available on the internet, research made on Kantar, and this research refers to the UK, but also you see a lot of reports from Kantar for at least in the last 5 weeks was released three reports on brand communication. So from one of these reports, I took this slide present us the tribes, the categories of the people related with their habit during these times. And they are divided according with the degree of being worried or less worried with this situation, and how they are seeking updates less or more frequently. So here is a short description of these tribes. I will not insist too much on this because you can find on the Kantar studies and also in this presentation. What I want to add is that we can move also from tribe to tribe. We can stay more time in one tribe and then go to the other, because probably it's you can find yourself in this situation. You remember in the first week of the lockdown, we have a shock. This could not happen to us. We go through a denial phase that COVID-19 is something that it's very far in Asia, and then go to this process of acceptance, even some kind of depression, of being psychically affected of what happening, and wanted to be back to the normal and so on. And then we start to experiment, to take decisions, and be engaged. engaged. The same, even the brands follow this kind of behavior. Okay, now let's go to the economy. How economy was affected. So how economy is affected or will be affected in the medium and long term. For the future, it's very hard to predict, especially for the medium and long term. But some trends, it's clear. As you saw that all over the world, healthcare systems was more or less prepared. So for sure, what happened in any countries, even Germany or Singapore or Korea or other country that was well prepared to the others that was is now are showing that is less prepared, will be a positive change in the healthcare. Also, the telemedicine will be developed. Things, for example, in Romania was impossible a few weeks ago to recipe to be accepted, showing to the pharmacy on the on your phone. Now it's totally possible. And also a trend of buying local. It's a quite old trend, but now yes. Because of the shortage of different products, increase get a prominence, and also because of the negative impact on the overall economy, it's clear that in order to sustain our economy, we have to buy more local products. Also, entertainment will be changed. You know that this media consumption increased. Some of the people move to the Disney Plus or to the Netflix and so on. Yes. I don't know after the lockdown will be lifted. If the people will stay in this kind of media consumption, some of them, of course, others will want to have a digital detox. Influence on the higher education, a lot of programs, a lot of courses will be online even in the future. Even in the will be totally normal because with this forcefully sampling of online classes, we saw that it can work. So for sure. It will be preserved, and also the economic condition will force us to will force some students to go to this version because will be more cheaper. Also, a lot of changes in the employer-employee relationship.
Yeah, and also the international activities. Our internationalization of the higher education institutions will also change, I guess.
Yes, it's exactly like I spoke with my students. Unfortunately, I do not have enough time with the students from the first year to get more deeper in this subject of marketing environment. And SWOT analysis and all this one, because all this changing in the environment, it's in the same time opportunities and threats.
Yes.
So
yes.
Now we can look at this impact on higher education, like decreasing the internationalization. Yes. So many students that wanted to go now. They are changing their plans and will stay home, or students that was in mobility coming back. But in the same time, for example, what we are doing now, it's another kind of internationalization. So we are having the same class, even it's at the distance, Brazilians, French students, and Romanian students. So that's opened a lot of possibilities. With one of my group of students from the third year, the first professor that I was guest lecturer was Eric Costa from Tupa Communication, from the advertising agency from Brazil.
So, yeah, he's here today.
Ah, it's here. Perfect.
Yeah, he sent you a hi.
So actually, one week before, I spoke with my students that it'd be very hard to bring a guest lecturer from the advertising industry because they decided to have the classes on Monday. And the previous scheduling was on Friday. So they was better for them to be on Friday. And I told them it's very, very difficult for me to bring a guest lecturer from the advertising industry from Bucharest, for example, because Monday it's working. Friday it's more easy because it's close to the weekend and so on. But exactly after 1 week, I have a guest lecturer not from Bucharest but directly from Brazil. So from this perspective, you can see this crisis was an opportunity for. I had a lot of other guest lecturers for this group of students and for other programs.
Right.
Okay, let's go now. Not to the industry overall, but to the different categories, because categories are also affected in the different ways. Are affected big international companies like Zara, for example. So they are not selling clothes now because so if they are selling clothes, they are selling online. Ah, it was a funny, for example, I read I think it was 3 or 4 weeks ago about a big shopping network in the United States that they are declaring they are selling more top part of the body clothes than bottom part.
Of course. That's nice. Nobody needs the bottom part now.
Yeah, if I can make a joke, for example, I you can see I have on the upper part I have a Grupo Unis Welcome to the Future shirt.
Okay, great.
Yes, with this shirt that also was bought from Brazil. But on the other part, the bottom part, it's a Romanian pyjama. So,
I'm wearing shorts right now.
Okay. Also affecting big companies in the small companies. Of course, this all that means Horeca, hotels, restaurants, cafeteria was.
Okay.
Heavily affected but some of them managed to attenuate to smooth this this problem of sharply decreasing the sales, so they are starting to deliver home to have a home delivery. And I put here an example of one restaurant that recommend to the foreign visitors that came in Brasov. But also this example I can add to other slides because they are preserving the same values of the brand. So they are continuously buying ingredients from the local suppliers. They have the same friendly and meaningful communication. So it's changed, but in the same time, remain the same.
Yes.
And also other companies, big companies, was affected like this from Lufthansa. I took this image. Okay, we are in this together now, but in the future some will disappear because only the big companies will remain. So the big big hit, big loss will be for company. If we discuss about this category of transportation, low cost company will be heavily, it's already heavily hit, but will remain in the future too. Let's go something to the now to the brand communication, exactly to the topic, but it's better to all the time to discuss about the context, because brands are not floating in summer. They are linked, they are part of this economic and consumers universe. First of all, almost all the brands that took a position. So from this, what happened in this this week, this term of social brand engagement, it's even an article, the this graph that I display here is from the Cozinet. It's an article. Not an article. It's a small chapter in the book that appeared in 2014. But let's see, for example, what Clifton said in 2009. The future of brands is also inextricably tied to the future of society. So brands are have to be active actors in the society. So now more than ever. These theoretical thoughts, are seen to be in practice. I will not insist too much here because of the out of time. I think I still have only 20 or 25 minutes. But for example, this kind of engagement can be framed in one of these four quarters of the graph, depending of the this kind of consumer-led engagement, or could be company-led engagement, building intimacy in the relationship, or build excitement in relations. For example, it was before relations between a commercial center from Romania and the NGO that started a big program of raising funds in order to help hospitals from Brasov. And now, because of this crisis, this cooperation for a good cause continues. So this relation between an NGO between a social cause and a brand become even more meaningful and deeper. Or, for example, what are how to make social brand engagement now in these times? For example, Disney, because you know Disney parks are not operating, are not operating now, but they are communicating with their audiences on the topic of thematic parks. I have to recognize I haven't been in the Disney park, but an example taken from the internet. So there, it's this kind of cookies, churro bites. So, so now there make people how learn people how to make these churro bites in order to keep in their mind the taste and the smell of. Of this, this is a maybe Romanian students that are now present here. will be intrigued why I put this kind of, because in this time a lot of jokes goes on the internet, and I will translate. It's the magic of the Easter. It's real because the guy that took your driver license will come with a candle. So I have to explain, because in the Orthodox ritual, it's very important. It's very important ritual. So it was a lot of discussions in the social media about a decision in Romania that then was reverted, about bringing this holy light to every house. And because first it was allowed, and police have to be part of this sharing the light, but with a lot of dangerous things. And in this case, the brand is the state, the Romanian state. Start of the discussions on the social media. All this conversation in the social media made the state to change their mind, not to to encourage having only the online religious services, not having this part of the ritual. So, now very. No, I will skip this, but please I ask students to not forget. It's better to, I will take this one now, sorry, to copy and to put in the comment. Please put this in the comment section of the YouTube in order to not forget to look at this. It was a short film that impressed me a lot, because the main the speaker from the middle is the Czech Ministry of Health, a very young and nice good looking lady from the Czech Republic, health minister, that encourage Czech people to wear the mask all the time when they are going outside, and also show how explain how the influencers joined this movement, and because of the these influencers in the very short times habits was changed, and all the Czech people wearing mask, and the results can be seen, because wasn't so many cases and very few people deceased in the Czech Republic. So this wearing mask, it's a clear a solution, at least for the moment.
Yes.
Okay.
We have a question. I will just interrupt you a moment.
Yes.
Question from Diego Dalbain. How will companies like the aviation sector communicate the brand in this crisis? For customers traveling for work or tourism, how do you think they can focus their brand communication?
First of all, they don't have to spend money for nothing. First of all, they have to cancel the campaigns that was scheduled before. Yes, because they are promoting something that it's not useful now. If they have funds and they can help. They have to help. So if they can transport ill people in other countries, if they I don't know, any kind of help they can make. And first of all, they have to respect their employees. They give them benefits for staying home. Of course, if they have enough funds, because in the same time they have to be actively preparing for the comeback. And as I told you before, some of them will leave, and a lot of company from this sector will die, will be swallowed by the competition. But
here the government they are renting some flights to other countries to bring masks and things that the government is buying, then it's also a way to stay on in the game.
For example, I use not speaking now about transport companies, aviation company, but a company that make the transfer between my city to the airport. It's 2 hours, 2 hours and a half
travel
until Bucharest to the airport. And at the beginning, without any, they are totally put their cars at the being their cars. They are saying their cars are available to transporting doctors.
Great.
So they are not having other people to transfer from Brasov to the Bucharest airport, but we have cars, we want to help you. Then also other banks use this car company to transport the people in the more safety conditions to the but first, without putting any conditions, they say we want to help, we are helping with all the cars that we have.
Yeah, okay, great.
Let's go. And then brand communication. Go to the last part, the more, the most consistent part of the presentation. Some brand communication rules. First messages. What happened at the beginning of the pandemic? Brand communication should be focused on the health first. Yes, so people to take all the measures about their health, or how they are making the interaction with the brand healthy, how they are dealing with the healthy production, healthy employees. Then business responsibility. I remember one of my friend that have a company told my responsibility is to pay the taxes in time. So even if it's allowed to postpone the paying the taxes, he said, part of my contribution to this state, and this state also it's involved in the all this fight against the pandemic. Is to pay my taxes. So it's very important. It's very important to keep economy working. It's social listening. So being part of the listening and be part of the conversation, knowing what are the what things frighten or our audience, what are the trends, what are their thoughts. So for starting from this, they can propose solutions to send positive messages. Fear is not a communication ingredient. Romanian students know this Romanian example. A company of the biggest company from Romania that sell bread took an old advert that was very scary, with a guy that coughing and something like that. And they thought that now is the moment to to tell the people that it's important to buy bread that is covered with the that is in the plastic bag. So, but they are telling in the way that it's not appropriate, and for this reason, our I don't know in English how it's said. I think it's some kind of supervision of the TVs. So it's a board, it's a governmental board, and yes, they are forbidden after one week or 10 days of broadcasting this advert. They are saying is not allowed to be on the public media, and I don't even find this on the YouTube after. let me check the phone. I still think we have 20 minutes. Also, I will as an example of good example on health first. Sorry, I will copy this Edeka. It's the shopping center from Germany. And yes, okay. I kindly ask the students to look later on this one. It's a very nice example.
Okay.
Going back to the presentation now. About this responsibility. The most important for the brand is to do. Yes, it's more important than to say. So it's another way of answering at the previous question. So it's not very important to communicate now, even for the companies, aviation companies, to do something, to make something that that help society, not your customer. Not do not think of your customers. Think of society on the overall. For example, the very quick response that LVMH, yes, this group of luxury brands, that's very at the very beginning they said, okay, now people are needing for disinfectants, so we are starting to produce the disinfectants. So for it's not any profit from this, so they are making this for free for the hospital. But they are showing that they are caring. I put in the contrast this attitude of the China. So they are helping, of course. They are sending planes with the but in the same time, it's obvious that also they are doing this with the PR purpose. So, like trying to please a potential, let's say, audience in Italy or other countries. For in this, and then it was shown that was true, because if you are more oriented to do, not to say, so in this case they are they don't have to not cover what happening at the before. So just a few days ago I read that it's forbidden to be published academic papers related to COVID-19 without permission of the party, Communist Party.
Yes.
So that's saying something about saying and not doing. So it's the big question mark about this attitude. So it's more important to do, not to say. But now it's, let's say, in a slide that contradicts me a little bit about what's happening, what I told you before. For example, what to do? First of all, to do what you are specialized in. So, for example, a bank doesn't have to put their employees to, let's say, to make masks or protection clothes. Yes?
Yeah.
They can, and I'm sure they can. They have to postpone some rates or to decrease interest rate or something like that. Yes?
Mm-hmm.
In this case, Heinz, they are making food, so they are contributing to this children breakfast in the UK. But what I put the second question, how to say, for example, this Selgros cash and carry from Romania, they are providing 250,000 portions of food for doctors, for the medical personnel, and for people that are working in the police. They are in the first line of battling against COVID-19. So they are just make a press release. In this case, I rather suggest to also use some more creativity in saying that you are doing good. So not saying very loudly, not putting communication first, but you can, let's say, close this good thing that you've done in the way like Heinz does. Now it's a time of creating communities or activating communities that already have. So in left side, we have this IKEA. So IKEA cannot sell too much things in this in this period, because also IKEA, it's related with an experience of going there to see exactly how it's looking. And then also they are not selling things that now it's not the time for the long time planning, like a lot of stuffs from IKEA are. But they are keeping their community warm. Yes, because most of us remember these meatballs. Even the smell of the that part of the IKEA. So in order to have a warm conversation, a nice conversation with their community, they are disclosing their this recipe for meatballs. Or the other example, this is for um, side that have this some classes, if I can say that, for calming and psychological healing. And in this period, because people, a lot of people need for this, they are giving this for free. Yes, for in this case, they are creating a community, a new community that can be fruitful in the future. Authenticity. So the message that you send in this period have to be part of the identity. So brand identity. So for example, Zisk. It's some kind of IKEA, but much smaller. They are donating to the hospitals things that are related with what they are doing, pillows and shields and so on. So
great.
Again, not giving financial advices or other things that is out of their competence. So even if you are doing things now or communicating according with the current situation, have to be linked with your brand identity. And also this example from Guinness, when they are saying in their own way, stay at home. Yes. Okay. Collaboration. I was impressed with cooperation between two big rivals, Apple and Google, that team up to work at the COVID-19 tracking app. A lot of news about was like a like a new hippie movement, but in online. All the people saw the good parts that now we are saving the planet. It's less pollution, and will be a new person after this. And maybe influenced by this conversation in online, and by this concrete cooperation between Apple and Google, I thought that there are much more cooperation between rivals. But I didn't find. For example, this McDonald's and KFC was just a communication, let's say, trick used during the Valentine's Day. But for the concrete cooperation, collaboration in order to solve the big problems, was very hard for me to find. Actually, impossible to find cooperation between competitors, because. Mm-hmm. I rather say that it's better now to forget that we are competitors on a specific market, and try to cooperate in order to solve the problem. Because then, if we save our market, we'll meet again. But we'll meet again on the live market, not on the very affected market.
Yes.
Okay. You know the definition of brand. The brand is a promise. So what the brands have to do now is to make promise, very concrete promise, and to keep it. Yeah. For example, here it's in Carrefour. It's a something very not emotional. It's very rational, very practical. So they are saying, until the Easter, all for 500 products, products that is from the first necessity, like flour, oil, and so on, we will have the same price. Doesn't matter if they're our suppliers will change the price and there will be a shortage.
Yeah.
Do not go, not make queues in our outlets. We keep the same price for a longer period. So this is a very rational promise that was kept. In the same time, but now I have to propose to look together at this because it's my favorite from all the adverts that I saw in these weeks. Mm-hmm. And this comes from the heavy affected country, from Italy.
Italy. Uh-huh.
And I will copy this. In the comment, and I propose you to look together, and after seeing this this advert, to come back to the discussion.
Okay.
First, I will block my microphone. I will look together with you.
Okay.
Just a minute. Okay, I post it.
Okay, I will put it there.
Yeah. Okay.
On the chat. Just a minute.
I will mute my microphone and then I will come back. Okay, I hope that it's
very beautiful.
Yes, it's a goosebump yeah, all the time when I saw. So actually, what is the promise? That everything will be okay. So
yeah,
it's a promise that will be kept. Yes, not because of the Barilla, but they are joining hopes with our hopes, with others, brands that communicate with other entities, other organizations that communicate, and together we create hopes, and for sure they are bringing their they are part in order to make us to overcome this bad situation.
Yes.
Okay. And then, what will be the future for the brands after seeing these slides of what is happening now? if you are looking in the right side, we'd be fine, at least for the strong brands. Here is the again from the Kantar study, from one of their studies that that show the evolution of the value of the brands after the 2008-2009 crisis. So as you can see, they are increasing a lot. So some of the brands will disappear, lost of their value, but the big brands then will continue to increase. So now it's a challenge, is a big threat for the brands, but in the same time it's opportunity. So the the brands that are based on the real values, the brands that even before are defining themselves as brands that give solutions, that are built around solving problems of the people, now will make this the same or better, or solve the new problems that appear, and for sure in the future they will increase. The other players that are on the market just for making money will not survive, because we'll be with a big shortage of money in the future. So demands by categories will be changed a lot. Some will increase, like for the digital services, for example. Others will almost disappearing. Will be a greater use of mask and protectors in the future. A lot of will be a big demand for apps for testing and tracking this COVID-19. Also, will be big changes in the spending rate, economy rate. So this what the consumer habits now regarding with the spending and making economies will be changed a lot. Also, it's a big uncertainty about sports. What will the sports will look like in the future? What will be the relation with the brands, with the relation between the brands and the sports as the driver for communication? What will be the gatherings? How will be the big concerts that very often are used in, was a good channel in order to communicate with the target audience? What will be our habits about eating out? What will be the future of Horeca? I remember the times when I worked for the beer that it said that the image of the brand, it's made in Horeca, in the off-trade, in the supermarkets you just sell, but the image, the real image is created. But that was said I think 20 years ago. Okay, what will be the brand marketing? What is the next steps? I took these steps from the Harvard article. You can find this, just Google it, it's for free. This step is present with empathy and transparency, use media in a more agile way, associate your brand with a good cause, track trends and build scenarios. So again, research, and plan, do, review. Yes. We are in a very changing environment, that changing from day to day, even hour to hour. So for this reason, have to be prepared for with many scenarios, and and adapt to a new way of working to keep delivering the promise. Here is an example, a Brazilian and Romanian and Brazilian example. you know this campaign that started in Brazil from the Brazilian agency and then broke the social media, so other brands also use it, like Volkswagen. So Separandos por, okay, so this is
I didn't see it
for communication, but this is originated from Brazil. So an mm-hmm. advertising agency from Brazil do this. And on the right side, it's an image from Brasov. So this is our main pedestrian street from the old city. At the end of the street, you can see the black church, but not for this reason I put this this image. Okay, you are in the sky, you are planning, you are reviewing, okay? But be careful at the execution. So you are communicating, you are saying about this physical separation, so physical mm-hmm. distancing, but Glovo delivers are staying one in other. You see?
Uh-huh.
So this is the difference between what you are saying, between the promise and what you actually does on the small scale. So all this process have to be carefully managed from the top to the every detail to be assured that all the members of the channels are doing in the according with the strategy.
Yes.
Here it's another steps, brand communication steps recommended by Edelman, Trust Barometer Special Report, show up and do your part, don't act alone, that cooperation that have to be built, cooperation with the consumers, cooperation even with competitors. Solve, don't sell, and mm-hmm. Communicate with emotion, compassion, and facts. And this is the last slide. So be adaptable. So this is the keyword for execution. So be ready for change that you never imagined, never planned before. Be creative in communication. Advice for small businesses, maybe some of them, or not some, more most of the examples from the this presentation was related with the big brands, but this is mm-hmm. Very actionable by the small brands, by the small companies. Create sales friendly websites, so a lot of new users of the online shoppings come now in the team, so they need for a very friendly websites. User interfaces and user experience have to be the focus now. Mm-hmm. Not good looking, not so. Just planning all this experience of shopping online. Using small tools like Google Maps or Google Business, increasing search engine marketing budgets. Why? Because now people are looking for, they are knowing exactly what they want to buy. For these reasons, allocate most of the money in this direction. This is an advice for the small companies. Okay, and thank you very much. Now I'm available for the questions.
Yeah, we have comments, and
I will see them on the YouTube later. Now I'm not on YouTube because not to create microphony.
Yes. And
but if there are questions, please add them in this chat on the platform.
Yes. Yes, no, not so far. We don't have questions. We have comments from saying hi, from UNIDEP, from ITEPAC Porto. There are universities from our consortium that is, they are watching us. And we have also people on the Facebook watching us too.
Okay. But
I guess they are shy.
I'm all right.
So,
I will plan my my offline meeting with your students for the next year, starting from this from these comments. So the first place where I go, it's first place is will be this one that.
Yeah, was, that's great.
The students from the audience. I hope that in the next February or next August to have this UX tour.
Yeah, we have here a question. Yeah, how coronavirus crisis will change the teaching of marketing in the universities? Question from Samil Cajalo. Cajalo, I'm sorry if I...
It's
from Finland. Hi.
Is my friend from Finland.
Great.
First of all, this is an example. By this class, it's a kind of way of convincing you, Sami, to join UX experience and to be... as you can see, it's this is an example of... opportunities that this coronavirus brings to us. So making some of us to be more sharply involved in this kind of, in this online teaching. So for me, it's, I had the first online teaching experience in Brazil. Exactly 1 month and a half when I was there. So other colleagues of mine never have this this experience, but in some of them in 1 day, in 2 days, others in 1 week, becomes very good on this teaching online. So of course, students wasn't used to this this kind of teaching. We lose some this part of interaction with the students. But even even here, it's possible to organize. For example, I use with my students Skype. In the Skype, you can make polls in the chat, so you can use there, or two or three or even four can be simultaneously with the microphones open. So you can have this kind of live chats even by Skype. So I think it's the change is for good. It's for good, but of course we cannot. We cannot get rid of the traditional way, because that eyes contact, that instant feedback that you receive from audience cannot you cannot have in the online class. So this vibe of teaching in front of your students, but I think a combination between two types will be the future, and the balance toward the online teaching, it's clear, and I think it's for good. Right. Sami, I answered the question.
I guess so. Let's see. We have other questions here also. And it was a pleasure to hear from Sami then. André, can you put the next question, please? Okay. It's interesting. That's a very difficult period for all the business. Mm-hmm. We have to communicate, but also we need to sell in this period. How can we do it in order to have gentle selling?
Oh, but if Joanna can explain me more about gentle selling, what you wanted to say with the gentle selling?
Let's see if she can answer it. She's in Facebook.
Joanna, it's my student and also knows Portuguese because was for 4 months in Madeira.
Oh, great. while she's writing down there what she means by gentle selling, I will just read here for you what Sami answered. He said, thank you. I think this opportunity to change teaching more practical, up-to-date, and international. Your session today is a great example of that.
Thank you. And I hope I convince Sami to be one of your lecturers at UX.
Yes, if he allows us, we can get in touch. And then it will be a pleasure. Joanna says, I mean, you don't... Okay, I mean to don't be like, buy it, we need it. Maybe to be a little bit more gentle in the way of telling that you want to sell it, but not just...
These times and in the near future, for sure will survive companies that will be more selling oriented in the near for sure. So the companies that will adapt to this being able to have a quite normal cash flow will survive. But on the other hand, we have to be aware that very hard question, because it's clear, but on the other hand, if you are if your potential consumer are feeling that you are just wanted to take his or her money from the pocket, will choose another option.
Yeah, I have an example from one. It's a tourism company here in Brazil, and right in the beginning, they put on an advertisement saying "stay at home," and they it's actually against everything that they are selling. Stay at home, just plan your next trip with us. So as it's like postpone it, but stay with us and plan it with us.
Yes, it's a paradox. It's an opposite. In the same time, you have to act in the very clever, in the very wise way of being selling oriented. So not thinking in a very long term, like creating awareness, creating an image in order to raise the profile or your brand of your brand and so on, but in the same time, so that means being very selling and cash oriented. But in the same time, you have to be authentic. You don't have to fool your consumer, because if you can make money without fooling your consumer or prospective consumer, prospective customer, it's okay. If not, so if you try to fool this consumer just in order to have a short-term cash in order to survive, and then we'll see in the future what happened, this will not work. This lie will not work. So it's some kind of opposite advice. So look on the sales, but in the same times, don't look just on the sales. But it's like in life, just being correct with yourself and with the others.
Yeah. Yes, it's not the time to disappear, but you have to be careful with what you're adding.
Yes, careful, especially you have to be more cost oriented, to look at your pocket and to cut all the expenses that are not necessary.
Yes. Okay. She's asking here, it's a combination between PR and marketing, isn't it?
Joanna knows that at my classes I told them they are PR doesn't exist. So I teach at the communication and PR program. So it's very strange to say that we don't have the PR doesn't exist. Why? Because doing the right things, this is the PR. So if you are doing the right product, if you are focusing on the needs of your clients, so all of these are part of the marketing, then good words about you, and this is PR, will come. So or if I to not be so harsh to say that PR doesn't exist, PR is the part of managing the flow of communication of these good words, but only if you are doing the right things. So if you are having the correct price, if you are having the correct product, if your company is built around some values, are built around serving your clients or future clients, that will goes after in PR, in good words about you. We cannot put the words between before the facts.
Yeah, that's a great one. I guess we have a last question from Diego Dalben. Is it, André? So this pandemic consolidates a new era of digital marketing services for the future?
Yeah, for sure. For sure. It was a some kind of forcefully digitization of many activities. So a lot of activities moved online. Our part of our life move online. So of course we are, because of this, we are skipping many years of normal development in this area. So we burn many steps in this area. But this also remembers me with the discussion that I have with my students at the other class that I don't even mention on my second slide of teaching mm-hmm. digital branding. And the topic of the entire class, even more, and the second, is it branding different than digital branding? And after spoken with the agency that defined themselves at the beginning as being a digital branding agency, we arrived at the conclusion that is no difference. So in digital, it's doing the same. It's the same principle that for branding. So doing the right things, having values, building a personality of the brand, all the things that you are was doing in the pre-digital times are the same even in the new context. Only the way of linking brands with consumer will have a bigger balance to the digital tools.
Okay, great. I guess, Florin, we have now 1 hour and a half, 90 minutes.
Wow. Of
life. So I guess it's time. Unfortunately, it's time to end. But we will leave this recorded video on our YouTube and also our educational platform. If you allow me, we will write down also an ebook each webinar.
No,
welcome to the future. Great.
No, it can be so better.
Yes.
And,
so if you can send us the presentation, then we can together write down a book with about what we learned today. It was great hearing from you. Great life also. And I hope we see you soon.
Yes.
Both here in other webinars and also in flesh and blood.
Yes, and my colleagues, two colleagues of mine from the Transylvania University will join in the next weeks. And I hope that I convince Sami to join from Finland.
Great, great.
Okay.
I hope it too. So, okay.
Bye.
Bye-bye. See you soon.
Bye. See you, bye.